For proud Tennessee, it was a stinging defeat. Not only was the eight-time national champ knocked out in the first round of the NCAA women's tournament, but it was by Ball State, a program making its tournament debut. The Lady Vols had never failed to reach the regional semifinals in their storied history, and while the defeat to Ball State may have surprised some, AP sports writer Doug Feinberg was not among them.
If there's ever a year that Tennessee was going to lose in the first round or the second round, this was it. 29 straight years they had been to the third round of the regional semifinals, and this year they didn't make it because they had five freshmen on the team this year. They had lost their entire starting five from last year's national championship. They were having the worst year in the history of Tennessee basketball with 10 losses, now they have 11, and the Pat Summit didn't really know what to do with the freshman class, but this was the year that they were sort of vulnerable. They had their worst seed ever. They were their 5 seed, which is unbelievable to think that the entire history of the tournament, they've never been lower than a 4 seed until this year, and they're a 5.
Ball State went into the game, justifiably, with a healthy respect for Tennessee. But that didn't keep first-year head coach Kelly Packard's Cardinals from outplaying the defending national champs.
So they respected them, but they weren't afraid of them. And they actually took it to them. They went to the basket. They weren't afraid to go in the paint.
While the loss shocked the Tennessee players, Coach Pat Summit said it could provide motivation.
I mean, she's already said that these kids now, who will be sophomores next year and juniors, will have a nice chip on their shoulder because they're the first team to lose at Tennessee and not make it to the regional semifinals. So they're going to be working hard in the offseason, which for them starts today, which is something that's never happened before.
And it's something Summit, college basketball's all-time winningest coach, hopes doesn't happen again. Steve Carmazan, The Associated Press.